What is leadership? And is it worth dying for? These are two questions I had to ask myself very early in my career after a colleague of mine, a mentor, if you'd say, died of cancer. A disease that she believed she got from working in a horrible workplace most of her career. We worked for a large public sector organization. She was a senior manager. I was a newbie right out of school. Remember that feeling when you got out of school and it was your first job? That excitement, you felt you could change the world. Does anyone remember that feeling? That's what I had. And I walked into this organization, and just in the first few days, I began to look around. And the walls were beige. The desks were beige. The floors were beige. The chairs were beige. And I would soon find out that the people were beige. They were half-decent people, but they would show up every day just going through the motions. Just showing up at 8:30 and leaving at 4:30. And I already started to feel this niggly in my gut that said, I'm not sure this is the place for me. Well, as weeks went on, it became clear that my concerns were real. There was really nothing in that work environment that was creating a lot of inspiration for me. Decent people, decent managers, but everyone just showed up and went through the motions. Then one day, a colleague of mine, a senior manager named Zinta, came up to me and said, Vince, I'm trying to set up some committees to make this workplace a better place. Are you interested in helping me out? Before she could even say those words, I said, I'm in. Whatever you need me to do, I will be there. And so the committee started. And we started to implement a whole number of initiatives, all focused on trying to make this work environment much better. Much to my surprise, what I began to find was it started to actually have an impact. But when you look at leadership today, you really have to start asking yourself some questions. Because when you look at what's happening, the corporate scandals, the lack of confidence that employees have in senior management, companies that we can't seem to figure out how to grow, you really have to ask yourself and really come to the conclusion that leadership is broken and we've got to figure out how to fix it. To me, the real tragedy of all of this is that somehow along the way, we have just come to settle. We have lived in these organizations and we've come to expect so little from our leaders and from ourselves as leaders, and that is something we have to change. You get confronted with new opportunities, and every time you have to ask yourself, am I up for this opportunity? Do I feel I can actually be a leader that's going to add value? Because ultimately, to me, that decision is fundamental about what leadership is. To me, leadership is essentially an individual who looks around and says, you know what? I have to step up in this situation. I have to now step out of my comfort zone and try to make the world a better place. And that world can be your team. It could be your department. It could be your organization. It could be the community in which you live. It could be your kid's soccer team. Whatever it is, in the end, it's about a decision you make, and leaders have to make it. They have to be conscious that they are truly deciding to be a leader.